Let us analyze the previous two programs. In the first program, the computer has placed the variable k at the register of the CPU. That is, computer has not assigned any specific memory address to the variable k. In the previous program, in second program, we have displayed the address of variable k through the statement printf. Okay, so using this statement, we have displayed the address. This printf library function forces the computer to assign the memory location to the variable k. So is it clear? What happened is that in the first program, k is stored at the registers of the microprocessor. But in second program, because of the printf library function, k is stored at specific memory location in the primary memory. Clear? Now see, next thing. This variable k is stored after the array SAM10. After the array SAM. That is, after the last element of the array SAM. That is, after the last element. What is the last element? SAM9 is the last element of the array SAM, and hence k will be stored after the element SAM9. Is it clear? Now let us see the for loop, and here is the interesting point. You see, the for loop is incrementing the value of k after every pass. When k is equal to 10, the statement k star 3 gives the value 30, which we have assigned to the element SAM10. Clear? So this 30 value we have assigned to the variable to the element SAM10. But the element SAM10 does not exist. Why? Because we have crossed the boundary. That is, because the dimension of the array is 10 and the last element of the array is SAM9. And we have stored the variable k after the last element, that is SAM9. Clear? We know that the variable k is stored just after the last element of the array SAM10. Hence, SAM10 is nothing but memory location of the variable k. This statement is very important. What is that? SAM10 is nothing but memory location of the variable k. Hence, after the statement SAM10 is equal to k star 3, the value of SAM10 will become 30. That is, the value of k will become 30. And hence, the statement printf %d%d, the arguments are k and SAMK, will display the value of k is equal to 30 and the contents of the SAM30, that is the garbage. Remember that. This is a very funny program. The for loop is very important. You see, the last arbitrary value is garbage, but it is the content of the element SAM30. Now again, you see, I have modified this program to clear this point. You see, SAM%D I have inserted over here, and let us compile this program and see the output at DOS prompt. You see, after k is equal to 9, k will become 10. But 10 into 3 is equal to 30, and that value we are assigned to the SAM10. Okay, and what is the content of SAM10? What is the SAM10? SAM10 means k, and that's why value of k become 30, and then SAM30 is this garbage. Is it clear to you? Understood the working? So insertion, because of the insertion of this printf library function, we got a very interesting result. Understood the role of this specific printf library function? Thank you.